So this is one of those moments in life where I just feel like, how did I get here?
It feels so soft and squishy. It's like a little cake.
There you are.
Everybody, hello. I'm the pig whisperer.
I want the master ball in this claw game. It's right there. It's got my name on it.
Oh my goodness. This is probably the most fun street food I've ever eaten. Hey everyone, welcome back to another beautiful day in Japan. In our last video, we said goodbye to Tokyo and hopped on the world famous bullet train bound for Osaka.
Osaka is known to have its own distinct personality, so over the next 2 days, we'll be exploring the ins and outs to see what the city is all about. This is probably one of the most iconic places to visit when you're in Osaka.
But today, I think I'm glad that we can't buy souvenirs because I think the Miko will buy this whole store. To our first stop of the day, we are going to make a very quick pit stop to pick up a very special person. Our friend Claire just arrived in Osaka last night from Australia. She booked a super last minute flight to come here and join us here in Japan for the next little bit of adventures. And now all that is left is to pick her up.
Where is she?
What are you doing? I was going to stay. And then you're like...
Alright guys, we have made it to Shinsekai, which is like a very colorful, bustling entertainment district.
Claire,
I'm trying to vlog here, okay? It's like just like a really cool walking district.
I feel like there's all these big like objects though on the outside of buildings, like people's heads and turtles and stuff.
This place really feels like a more like an amusement park or like a theme park with different arcade games, and I think you can really spend some time here and have a lot of fun. I want the master ball in this claw game. It's right there. It's got my name on it.
I gotta watch from this.
That's so intense. Come on, darling.
Ready?
Don't let me down. 100 yen.
Oh, no! Oh!
Master ball. Whatever it's called. I don't know. Just do it. The claw hates Claire. And now we're out 300 yen. So you can play games in this neighborhood. What's the neighborhood called again?
Shinsekai.
They're the ones you could have gotten.
Oh.
I want the haunter. What the heck, Claire?
Back at it.
All right.
What I was trying to say is that at Shinkansen, one of the things that you can do that's really popular is come to some of the little game spots and play a game.
We found, I think, a pretty nice restaurant, and the reason why we say that is that there are no other foreigners here but Nicole, Claire, and I. After a little bit of help from Google Translate, we have ordered ourselves like what seems to be like a nice Japanese feast for lunch today.
I managed to find some yakisoba. Pretty sure there's meat in here somewhere. We also think this is garlic. What's it called? Gyoza?
Yeah.
Gyoza? Dumplings, yeah. That look amazing. This all looks so good. And of course, Miko got ramen.
I got myself a ramen.
Miko's had at least one ramen a day since we came to Japan.
Yeah, every day it's like one ramen and a couple onigiris. That's how I get by eating in Japan these days.
Oh my god. It's so good. Like, exceptional. I won't lie, I've only had... What is this called again?
Yakisoba?
Yakisoba from like a fast food chain in Canada. And let's just say, this is way better.
Flesh eater.
But like,
but wait, you know I cried that whole time.
I love Ito so much. But now that I have had this, I'm never gonna want to eat it again. I'm really trying to learn my chopsticks, guys. It's embarrassing.
I want to hear my girl hang on.
Cover that before they see it.
Where have you been this whole week? I've been struggling.
Oh my god, so embarrassing.
We're all ready for this. Na-na-na-na.
So this stop we're really, really excited about. It's not really something that you would see in a lot of guides for Osaka, but it's something that we just have to do. But first, we're gonna get kitted up.
All right, time to blend in.
So for tonight, we decided to go to one of the famous baseball games here in Japan. Japan is a huge fan of baseball, and I thought it was such a cool idea to go enjoy a sport that the locals love so much.
How do we look?
It's like you're a tourist, and you bought the cheapest thing possible and blend in.
Yeah, I did do that. Yes. That's exactly what we are. It's fine.
We got tickets! So really quickly, I will say that getting these tickets was a little bit difficult. I used like the main Japanese website and navigated through it with the help of my brother who can speak Japanese. Some easier options that are more foreigner friendly are like third-party websites. I think like, for example, Klook. You can use those websites to buy the tickets, but they do have quite a bit of a markup on them. These tickets were only 1600 yen per person, which I think is pretty good.
Moments in life where I just feel like, how did I get here? You know, like I'm in a baseball game in Japan.
Oh,
with like knockers for a team I don't know. I don't think it matters though. We're just here for the spirit. But despite that, this was still a lot of fun. If you have some time when you're in Osaka, highly recommend catching a baseball game.
All right, everyone, we have made it
to Dotonbori. This is probably one of the most iconic places and most popular places to visit when you're in Osaka. It is known for its buzzing atmosphere, bright neon lights, signage everywhere, and a really kind of overwhelming attack on the senses here in Japan. I'm already feeling the atmosphere here.
This is live music.
I swear we're seeing the same guy in Tokyo.
I swear we did too.
So yeah, this is the kind of stuff you'll find in Dotonbori. You know, you got some people beatboxing, using slippers to play on some pipe instruments, and we're like on the bridge that is over a canal, I guess.
The canal is the Dotonbori Canal. That's how like the Dotonbori neighborhood got its name.
Yeah, it's a cool place to watch some people play with slippers and also see all the neon lights down the canal.
Do you mean flip-flops?
Flip-flops. Everybody put your hands, everybody put your hands, everybody put your hands, everybody, let's go!
We found the Glico Man. This is like the most famous sign in all of Osaka. Well, all of Dotonbori, at least. It's this guy right here. He's been here since 1935. I guess Glico is a big like candy company here in Japan. And so he's been here advertising Glico candy since 1935. I'm pretty sure I just heard a Japanese woman say Glico, not Glico. So that's my fault.
So I think Dotonbori is just like one really long walking street and it goes down that way. Super far that way. We're trying to find some food first though before we tackle off this street because it might be a bit of a walk and there's going to be a lot to look at. Osaka is known for having so much good food, and Dotonbori is a really good place to get some of that great food. I opted to get myself one of these. This is takoyaki, and I've always wanted to get this. It's like chopped up octopus in a wheat batter. You mix the octopus, the batter, you flip them a whole bunch of times, and then you toss them together with some sauce, looks like some mayo and some flakes. I don't really exactly know what it is. It feels so soft and squishy. It's like a little cake. Good. I like the very seafoody kind of taste, but it's a lot squishier than I thought it was gonna be. I thought it was gonna be like a meatball where it's like stiff and like firm throughout, but it's actually kind of squishy in the middle. Look at that. Oh, I can see a little bit of the octopus too. And I am absolutely butchering this takoyaki.
You ordered this. One of the famous things to buy here is the 10 yen coin. 10 yen?
Yeah.
10 yen coin. Which I guess is like a pancakey outside and cheese on the inside. So it's a second dinner.
This is a Nicole Claire kind of meal.
I got no, there's no cheese!
You're gonna do a big like this.
Perfect. Oh, I got this bread so far. Oh! It tastes like waffle. That's delicious.
It is. Mm.
Oh my goodness.
It's very stringy. I feel like they melted a cheese string. Like, that's the kind of cheese it tastes like. It's really good.
These 10 yen coin stores are usually like super, super busy. So if you see one without a line, you should just jump on it and grab one.
This is probably the most fun street food I've ever eaten. I like this.
I think Nicole undersold this a little bit. This is really delicious.
And fun!
And fun.
So, something that I'm really loving about Japan so far, I mean really it's just Tokyo and Osaka, is that I feel like there's so much to do in the evenings. And it's like really safe and it's easy. You just like walk around, there's like endless entertainment. You could even do it without any spending any money, just like walking and enjoying like the sights and the atmosphere. I really, really love that about both Tokyo and Osaka. So one of the things that you absolutely have to do if you come to Japan is go to some sort of animal cafe. So we're at a micro pig cafe, and I don't know if you can hear them. Ah! I'm so excited, but the pig's just behind us.
Arigato.
Oh, hi! Oh. Hi!
He's trying to escape.
Hi! Oh. Is this happening?
We just sat down, we were getting blankets, and there's a pig.
Just crawled up.
But he, I feel like he's not like laying down all the way. He's like sitting up kind of weird. What are you doing, dude? Look at this guy. No.
There are some small pigs that I would say that are micro pigs, and there are bigger pigs that I don't think qualify as a micro pig.
This is just like full on. There are so many pigs. There are also actually a lot of people in here. The lady told us to get a drink. You're supposed to get like a cup of coffee or something. She's like, get a drink before a pig comes and sits on your lap, or you might be stuck there the whole time. But the pig came.
Oh my freaking god.
I think he's just lying there.
Hi everybody. Hello. I'm the pig whisperer. Hi everybody. Yeah.
Oh my goodness!
Yeah?
He's like, I heard you weren't getting any pigs.
He scared away my baby pigs. But he's pretty cool too. Definitely one of the top things to do if you are coming to Osaka is come and hang out with the micro pigs.
We are making our way to Osaka Castle. I think we have to go through a pretty large garden area. Apparently there's like 2 square kilometers of gardens around the castle, so it is supposed to be a bit of a beautiful walk.
It is hard to believe that we are in a giant city because it's so beautiful, so green.
And there's a Starbucks.
Of course there's a Starbucks.
In case you want to start your Osaka castle viewing.
The very Japanese, there's a Lawson's over there.
There you go, and another convenience store in case you're hungry.
Hey, maronta yade, maronta.
Now he has to walk. Doesn't like the glare.
So automatically a big plus of walking around Japan is the amount of cute dogs you might see along the park.
But they're almost always in strollers.
They usually are in strollers.
They're actually usually really hard to like touch and feel.
I'm waiting for the cats.
Claire wants, Claire's here for the cats.
You know what, I have seen very few
which
cats.
Which you do find.
But rarely.
And mostly in cafes.
They're all rounded up.
They've rounded them up. I feel like this is a different kind of castle than I was expecting slash have seen before. I'm picturing like the UK.
You're thinking like a Disneyland castle.
No, I'm thinking like UK castles.
Yeah, like Rapunzel's gonna let down her hair.
Yeah, well, okay, yeah, maybe kind of like Disney, yeah. But like, I forgot we're in Japan, so it's a Japanese castle. Miko tells me I need to share with you castle facts. So this is one of the most important landmarks here in Osaka, like one of the most notable ones. It was very important in the reunification of Japan in like the 1600s. It's been like burnt down and destroyed and rebuilt many, many times, and now it is gorgeous.
So mainly they just worship cats here now?
Oh my god, that's what Claire's here for.
We should have come yesterday because they had a big ceremony.
Did they actually?
No! Oh.
Looks like tickets are 600 yen for one adult, which is pretty reasonable.
Tickets to go up, we should say.
Tickets to go inside the castle.
The garden was free.
Made it through the castle, which is like a really
like more like a museum where you can see all the history of the castle and how it was built and learn a lot about important historical figures. And at the top here, I think at the 8th floor, there's an observatory where you can have a great 360-degree view of Osaka.
Truly, the grounds, like the gardens here, is definitely, like, for me, the highlight because they're so sprawling. You could easily, if you wanted to, spend a whole day just walking around here.
It's not bad for 600 yen. To Shinsaibashi. This district is famous for a lot of good shopping. I'm on the Shinsaibashi shopping street, which is like a long street that's covered and it's filled with different restaurants and shops, and it's perfect to spend a day out here if it's raining all day in Osaka. Because for the best of the while, it has been a little bit rainy, so we decided to take the time to do something a bit more indoors. Shinsaibashi is also a really central place here in Osaka, and it's actually a really good spot, I would say, if you are looking for a place to stay. Claire and Nicole were doing some walking around and they said I have to come to the 9th floor of the Daimara building. And
yes!
In case you guys weren't aware, but I actually really love anime, and coming to Japan was really exciting for me because I loved finding some cool anime stuff, and I never buy anything, I just love knowing that it's all here and this is the birthplace of it. Oh, the Pokemon cafe is here too!
So oftentimes I'm really sad that like we never go back home really to Canada. Like we're traveling full time, so we can't ever really get souvenirs. But today I think I'm glad that we can't buy souvenirs because I think the Miko would buy this whole store.
It's not just your typical like plushies and like pens and Pokemon like paraphernalia. There's a Pikachu waffle maker, Pokemon pasta. The store has it all. And I am also very glad that we're not going back home.
Yeah, because we
there's some cute Eevee stuff there that you wanted.
Yeah, that's true. I do love Eevee. When I left Claire in line, she had 3 packages of gummies. And now look at this bag. Like, this is cool.
Yeah, that was $16. Maker was like, you should get it. I'm like, okay.
This is actually really cool.
Yeah, that's just hilarious.
This is shampoo.
Conditioner, I think it's a soap bottle.
I could use it for anything.
Anything.
Shampoo.
Yeah. Oh my god! How does this work?
Like,
oh my god.
So you open it up and it's butter-free.
No! You're joking!
I didn't know that the Metapod umbrella has a butter-free umbrella inside of the case.
This doesn't evolve!
It looks like it does evolve.
That's pretty cool.
The store is awesome.
The Shitanoji Temple, which is actually really cool. It was originally created in like the 500s. So although it's of course had to have a bit of a facelift every now and again, it's been here for a really long time. The whole thing is a Buddhist temple. And it's a holy site, but there's not a lot of people here. It's really quiet, really peaceful, a really nice way to spend a bit of an afternoon.
The pagoda, this 5-story pagoda, is so beautiful. And it's surrounded by this gravel that looks like it's been like almost like raked. Like perfectly, like you would a lawn.
So it turns out you can actually go up the pagoda.
This is super cool. Let's keep going up. I should also mention that you're not allowed to walk with your shoes in here, so they give you a little bag to put your shoes in. It's kind of funny, you just walk up pagoda holding your little bag of shoes. I was just thinking, we've actually gone up a lot of different towers today, but this is the first one where we actually have to walk all the way up the stairs ourselves. This one, the view is not as good, but I gotta say, it's pretty cool being in here.
It's very cool. Yeah, to think you're like in the top of the pagoda.
Yeah, so I didn't realize that. Thank you.
Okay, so the real reason we came to the temple is because we heard that there were turtles. So we're here to check out the turtle and the temple's next door.
We hope you guys enjoyed going around Osaka with us. In the next video, we'll be jumping out of the city and into the more rural parts for a different perspective of Japan.
If you haven't already subscribed, please do that. And if you like this video, give it a like. Thank you guys so much for watching.
Excuse me, sir. Are you a micro pig? You don't look very micro.